Good afternoon, Derbyverse. I'm Captain Lou Obamo.
I'm the Derby Nerd.
You are the Derby Nerd. And you're watching the 2016 International Wftda Division I Playoffs live from Montreal, Quebec, Canada, brought to you by the Women's Flat Track Derby Association and Montreal Roller Derby.
And we are set for a consolation showdown between our 27th-ranked Kallio All Colors and the Dallas Derby Devils Army of Darkness, who are coming in ranked 18th in this tournament and the 5th seed. Kallio, of course, coming in as the 7th seed in this tournament as well.
Well, get to the rosters, and we can talk a bit about this game. Dallas sending to the track in this game. 00, Blakely, 101, Acute Pain, 10-10, Bazooka Bubble Bum, 112, Planet of the Skates, 138, Anita Riot, 15, Hanna-Barbaric, 235, Guillotine Grace, 28, Miley Virus, 451, Animal Lee, 5, Jet, 55, 10, Nick's Victim, 82, Myth America, number 9, Bailey Wheat, and 9-11, Mona Bruiser.
And for the Kallio All Colors in this consolation showdown, we've got number 10, Layla Gay, number 103, Bella Glucosi, number 13, Mischief, number 13, 14, Picante, number 19, Kata Schrodinger, number 21, Schlagerloff, number 333, Valhalla, number 410, Watuvima, number 4444, Doomy Behind, number 49, Machu Picchu, number 60, KO, number 72, Pretty Sick, number 777, Sarah Gilbert, and number 9, Teabag. Kallio Rolling Rainbow, Kallio All Colors.
And the officials for this game will be the crew head referee, Umpire Strikes Back, Inside Pack, Izzy Demented, the jammer referees, Freddie Mercury Poisoning, and Fluke. And the OPRs will be Jean-Philippe Amand, Kurt So Good, and Parking Lot with our referee alternate, also known as the announcer ref, Wonder Zebra.
That's right. An excellent cruise we've had all weekend here.
So, Derby Nerd.
Yes.
I do not feel we have seen the true colors of the Kallio Rolling Rainbow. I think they had a bit of a rough start to their first Wftda playoffs at all yesterday.
Yeah, I don't know if it was exactly the nerves, new floor, new experience, the big stage for the first time, but Kallio came out a little hesitant, to say the least, in the opening 10 minutes of their showdown yesterday, and of course fell into a deep hole, taking 6 jammer penalties within about the first 5 minutes of that game, and they were never quite able to crawl out of it.
No, but even with those penalties that they took, they were still only really down by 10 points. They hung with Rocky Mountain as long as they possibly could, but man, just taking those penalties just really crippled their ability to put points on the board. You're right. Dallas, on the other hand, played a great game against Montreal last night, just didn't quite have what it takes to get past the hosts, but looked very, very clean against Montreal.
Absolutely, yeah, it was a very clean game. Dallas is a fairly clean game. They come in averaging only 25 total penalties in the game, about six for jammers and about 19 for blockers. So a very clean team, and they did play a great game last night, but Montreal's defense was just pretty much as strong as I've seen it all season, and they just couldn't quite catch the hosts. Montreal never quite pulled away, but they had a fairly comfortable lead throughout.
Now, opportunity is at stake in this game. Yes, you're on the consolation side, but if you lose this game, you're going to end up playing in the 9-10 game.
That's right.
Tomorrow morning at 10 a.m. against Sun State, who just lost to Boston.
Heartbreaker.
Just lost to Boston.
One-pointer. We've had some great games. Kallio, of course, that game we mentioned earlier against Rocky Mountain was a four-pointer yesterday, so we'll see if the Kallio All Colors can recover from that loss. Up on the Fast Girl State start line, it's number 72, Pretty Sick in the white for the Kallio All Colors, facing off against Anita Riot in the black for Dallas.
Whistle blows, derby underway. Pretty Sick looking to work her way on the outside. Once again, using the toe stop crawl along the outside line. We've seen her do it all weekend long. Picks up lead jammer for Kallio. Lead jammer was not a problem for Kallio yesterday. It was just keeping their jammer on the track. And it's those aggressive moves into the pack that Pretty Sick just did a power jam in the first jam of the game once again. Granted to their opponents, Pretty Sick off to the penalty box.
That's right, and Pretty Sick, you mentioned the lead jammer was not an issue. She had an 83% lead percentage yesterday, but only converted that into 3.8 points per jam.
Now, Anita Riot is not the lead jammer, as she has passed the star to Animal Lee. So Animal Lee is the jammer of record and will put the first 5 points in this game on the scoreboard as the power jam continues. Dallas freezing the pack on the far straightaway. Kallio sitting at the apex, waiting for the offense to come forward. Dallas springing forward, moving the blockers of Kallio out of the way. Nice rotation up on 1 foot. Completes the 360 and five more points for Dallas.
And KO had headed to the penalty box as well for Kallio, so she is now standing and pretty sick, heading back onto the track. So power jam is over, and KO follows her out for full pack for the all colors as well.
Pretty sick with 45 seconds to work with as Animal Lee continues to score points at the front. A forearm penalty is going to send Dumi behind to the penalty box. Pretty sick working her way through the front of the pack. The triangle formation of Dallas trying to hold her up there. One to beat, skips her way around, and she'll take 4 points from Dallas. 10 to make it 5 points, 10 to five in this jam. And Animal Lee slowing down her pace. Pivot turn jammer trying to put points on the board as time ticks down in the jam. 15 seconds remaining and a track cut being signaled to the blocker from Kallio. So that's Wftda heading to the penalty box and another 5 points scored by Animal Lee.
And Wftda will be joining Dumi behind. So two blockers in the box for the Kallio all colors. And meanwhile, number 235 heading to the box as well. Guillotine Grace for Dallas.
One additional point for Kallio, three more for Dallas, 18-6 to start off the game, nerd.
Make your skates your own with custom-colored, handcrafted Color Lab boots by Rydell Skates. Visit rydellskates.com. So, more jammer penalties for Kallio to kick off this game, but they did recover nicely, managed to put some points on the board, but nonetheless a 12-point gap, again, on the back of a power jam for Dallas.
Fast girl start line has Miley Virus for Dallas. Sarah Gilbert for Kallio. Sarah Gilbert with 6 penalties yesterday, getting sucked back into the pack again. Miley Virus working her way through the front. Only 2 to beat at the front. 1 teabag, can't keep her in the back. Spins her way around and off and running is Miley Virus. Sarah Gilbert being held up by the Dallas tripod. Army of Darkness doing a good job of holding the top jammer from Kallio in the pack at the moment. Miley Virus threw on the inside. She'll take 5. She's going to keep on going and to the penalty box. Once again, a track cut for Sarah Gilbert.
Happening again. Miley Virus, though, and Sarah Gilbert, their team's respective leading scorers yesterday. Sarah Gilbert putting up 64 points against Rocky. Miley Virus with 36 against Montreal and off to a quick start here against Kallio.
Yeah, Miley Virus with 10 points in this jam as the Dallas offense once again creates chaos in the rainbow. Miley Virus working her way through. Nice reset by Kallio to form the bridge. And now the tripod continues to work Miley back and forth across the track, slowing her up, checking the time, checking the clock, checking the bench to see whether she needs to keep staying out there. Sarah Gilbert still on her initial pass. They're going to make her keep on working. Still 47 seconds left in this jam and through for another scoring pass. Make it 15 points for Miley Virus.
And power jam has ended now. Jammer back on the track. Sarah Gilbert trying to work her way through this tough Dallas D. Meanwhile, Miley Virus back around and scoring once again.
Star pass or star stash in effect for Sarah Gilbert. See if she wants to pass it. Miley Virus will take another 4 points. A 19-point jam for Dallas. Pivot heading off for Dallas.
Schlagerloff has picked up the star now. Pivot is the jammer for Kallio.
Still being stuffed behind the wall of black. The tripod continuing to work her over. Miley Virus patiently at the front. Forces a multiplayer block on one of the blockers. That is Wftda heading to the penalty box for her second trip. Another 5 points. Huge jam for Miley Virus and jam number 2, nerd.
And there it is, the jammer penalties once again becoming a problem for Kallio. And you know, it wasn't an issue that bad this regular season, averaging just about 7.5 jammer penalties per game. We saw them pick that up again, as we mentioned, the first 5 minutes yesterday. They've got 2 here, 5 minutes in already, and have put themselves into a pretty big hole after that 24-pointer. 42-6 now is your score.
Fast girl start line. We'll see Layla Gay going up against Jet in jam number 3 of this game. Dallas stepping on the accelerator quickly because the advantage has been granted to them 2 jams in a row. Layla Gay, good lead jammer percentage yesterday, working towards the front of the pack. The tripod trying to stay static, but she's continuing to move them forward. Tumbles Guillotine Grace to the ground and then has to reset one more time. Guillotine Grace quickly back onto her feet, reforms that tripod at the back. Jet getting some assistance from her pivot. Bailey Wheat trying to provide offense to get her jammer through. And now cycling back up to the front is Machu Picchu trying to provide a last line of defense, but first through once again for Dallas. It is Jet, lead jammer.
40 seconds it took for Jet to pick up lead jammer status. Had only 38% lead jammer status yesterday in the loss to Montreal.
Rolling Rainbow playing solid defense yesterday. Again, the jammer problems continuing in this game. Layla Gay unable to make her way out of this pack, and Guillotine Grace tumbling to the ground one more time as she tries to play offense for Jet. Star Pass is finally going to get an active scorer out of the pack. That is Matthew Bichu.
Kallio averaged only one star pass per game in the regular season. We've already seen two here early on in this one.
So just a 4-0 jam, 46-6 now, Nerd.
Big shout out to Radar Wheels. Thank you for supporting this WFTDA tournament. Radar Wheels, part of the Rydell family. Coming up to the Fast Girl Skate start line, it's going to be acute pain for Dallas. Had 19 points yesterday against Montreal in the strength of a 60% lead percentage. She's going to be facing off against Pretty Sick, who, as mentioned, had that 83% lead percentage, also plus 32 in the plus-minus category.
Acute pain with a little bump on Pretty Sick as she tried to move to the outside, forcing her to the inside. The outside's a favorite line for Pretty Sick. See what she can do. Now she's back on the outside line, but being pinned at the back by Planet of the Skates up at the front.
Pretty Sick sitting on that one penalty from her first jam earlier on in this one.
And it's now Acute Pain who has moved that pack forward and now is wrestling with a tripod of rainbows at the front. Rolling Rainbows doing a good job. The All Colors holding strong. A forearm penalty is going to lose Blakely to the penalty box. Now only three blockers holding back. Pretty Sick. Bump out by Planet of the Skates. Do not keep her in the pack. But a track cut on Pretty Sick will send her to the penalty box. Took a toe stop wrong, Nerd.
And that's it. Two jams, two penalties for Pretty Sick. So it's deja vu all over again for Kallio All Colors here early on in the first half.
Now Acute Pain just hanging out, playing nice, safe jammer derby.
They picked up jammer penalties now on three of the opening four jams here.
Again, the blockers for Kallio holding strong. Mischief, Schlageloff, Valhalla, Teabag doing a great job. They stay in high rotation in this pack. And even with the offense coming forward for the Army of Darkness, the All Colors blockers are doing a great job of killing this penalty as Acute Pain is drawn back one more time. Power jam over Pretty Sick coming back onto the track. We do not have a lead jammer yet.
And this is what kept them in the game yesterday, and the reason they were so close was these strong penalty kills, and it allowed them to keep pace with Rocky Mountain. They're within 40 here, so still within reach, but they're going to have to get some offense working here to get their jammers through.
Tumbling to the outside is Acute Pain. Coach telling him to come on back. That's TJ saying, hey, get back onto the track. Time is going to run out in this jam. Nobody's getting anything,
wow,
though. Grueling.
No lead jammer status there. Great defense from both of those teams. So Dallas unable to take advantage of the power jam opportunity. I'm going to take this opportunity to thank Triple Eight. New helmets that protect against rotational violence with MIPS patented brain protection system. Find out more at 888.com. Three straight jams now without a score for Kallio. Coming up to the Fast Girl State start line is Sarah Gilbert going to try and turn that around for the All Colors.
And Bazooka Bubble Bum getting the first action of the weekend with star in her helmet for the Army of Darkness, and she's going to be lead jammer for Dallas. Sarah Gilbert bumped out of bounds, going to reset safely at the back of the pack. Got to make sure she does not take a penalty. Kallio Rolling Rainbow desperately need her to perform in this game in order to compete with Dallas. Bazooka Bubble Bum now being held up at the back, Doomy behind, holding her up.
Sarah Gilbert was their leading scorer in the regular season two, has now take the star off into her hands. Stash now frees her from the pack.
Successfully out of the pack. Penalty call just at the end of the jam as the whistle gets blown. Hands were on the hips. 4 points for Dallas. 50-6 is the score.
Lead so far 3-1 in favor of Dallas. Of course, at that one jam without a lead jammer status given. So Dallas just keeping a step ahead here at the 10-minute mark of this opening period of this consolation showdown here at the WFTDA Division I playoffs live in Montreal. Derby Nerd with Captain Lou. Kallio in white, Dallas in the black.
Anita Riot taking the star, number 138 for Dallas. She'll be going up against Layla Gay. Layla Gay pinned at the back, and Anita Riot through the pack and lead jammer already quickly done in under 10 seconds. Layla Gay at the front of the pack. Bailey Wheat's going to pick up a forearm penalty. Layla Gay out, but Anita Riot already around the track and through 4 points for her. She'll just call it off and take those 4 points back to her bench.
Wftda Montreal Roller Derby would like to thank these companies for their generous support of this weekend's event. Café Centropol, Bose Brewery for supplying us with delicious beer here at the Centre Pierre Charbonneau. I would like to thank Yelp Montreal and rollerskating.ca. Big shout out to those companies.
Kallio, all colors, continuing to roll with pretty sick. She's got two penalties already in this game, nerd.
Yeah, and again, as we said, we saw this yesterday as well. Kallio is able to recover, but if they can get clean quickly, they can get back into this game quicker as well.
Miley Virus taking the star for the Army of Darkness. Pretty sick. Almost through the pack, but then dragged back, and Miley Virus finds the gap and picks up lead jammer one more time for Dallas.
Kallio really strong in the defense, but we're not seeing that same kind of strength on the starts, and Dallas has been able to, except for that one jam, just kind of dominate right off the fast girl skate start line.
Pack goes into hustle mode as the points are trying to be kept out of the way. Dallas leading the way, trying to make sure that Miley Virus has a chance. Yell of victory, scream of triumph on 1 foot. She'll take 3 points as she calls it off.
Nice job, Dallas, speeding up that pack, just controlling the pace. Now picked up 5 of the first 6 lead jammers and just really controlling the game here early on. Kallio has not been able to get the offense going at all. And looking to change that up will be once again Sarah Gilbert, already out there for her 3rd jam for Kallio, and she'll be facing off against Jet. Jet had 25 points yesterday against Montreal.
Even though Sarah Gilbert had all of those penalties, she also usually got out of the pack first, but it is Jet who is accelerating through the front, gets past Valhalla, picks up lead jammer status. One more time, Dallas just dominating on lead jammer early on in this game.
Yeah, absolutely. Just those tight packs right off the start. It seems like it takes Kallio a little while just to get things tightened up in the pack. And they're not able to do it right off the start line.
Jet dragged back by Teabag as the all colors set up their defense at the back to greet the jammer on her scoring pass. Sarah Gilbert draws a direction of gameplay against Nick's victim. Now only 3 blockers for Dallas at the front. Out of play is going to be called. There's an out of play penalty is going to be called. Mm-hmm. So Dallas loses another blocker. Now only 2 blockers on the track for Sarah Gilbert. A little bit of discipline problems on Dallas during that jam. Sarah Gilbert going to accelerate through and pick up points, nerd.
Wow, Jet a little late on that call off, and 4 points picked up for Sarah Gilbert. 4-3, it's going to go into Kallio's favor, so big pickup there. First points since the opening jam for Kallio, so that was a streak of 6 scoreless jams. And finally now back on the board, and they did it without lead jammer status.
It never feels like Kallio is really out of these games. Down by 50 points, they've only scored 10, but now they've got a pack advantage out there. Actually, it's 2-on-2, so there is no pack advantage. Both jammers, lots of room to skate, and acute pain taking the start for Dallas. It's going to be Layla Gay for Kallio. Layla Gay working at the front. Pivot, Animal Lee holding her back with an assistant from Guillotine Grace. Now Guillotine Grace, the last line of defense. Layla Gay going to get through first. Lead jammer, Kallio. There goes acute pain. She rotates around the outside. She'll get through as well. Penalty being handed out to Machu Picchu. Freedom on the track, but it's going to be Layla Gay entering the pack first. See if she calls it off in time. She does not. Already through the pack untouched. That's acute pain for 4 points.
And once again, seeing Layla Gay, just like we saw yesterday in the game against Rocky, unable to take advantage of a very healthy lead jammer percentage. And instead, now Dallas is leading the scoring on this jam.
And the Dallas defense may not have been able to hold her up in the first pass, but doing a stalwart job in round 2. Push on Doobie behind, trying to open up that wall. Forearm penalty, though, going to be called on Layla Gay. Off to the penalty box goes the jammer for the all colors. Power jam. Dallas.
And that is the 4th jammer penalty already in this game, coming up just past the midway point of the first half. And once again, it's jammer penalties that are putting Kallio into this disadvantage.
Dallas using this opportunity to put another 4 points on the board. 4 points had already been picked up by acute pain before that penalty was called. Worked her way through the pack on that second scoring pass. Now looking to go through, big push by Doomy behind. Means that acute pain has to reset one more time. She's getting a wee bit of assistance out there from Nick's victim, trying to open up the wall. Trying to isolate one of the Kallio blockers, but then has to let her go. Power jam is over. Back on the track is Layla Gay. She is stuck at the back of the pack. Layla Gay is on a scoring path, so she's eligible to pick up points, as is Acute Pain. Acute Pain now being drawn back by Machu Picchu. Machu Picchu, the pivot for Kallio, doing a great job of dragging her to the back of the pack, killing more time off this clock. And time's going to expire, Nerd. See the fingers in the air. Two more for Kallio, five for Dallas.
Penalties kind of even right now. It is 11-6 in total. Kallio with the 11, Dallas with 6. But get rid of the jammer penalties, and we see that blockers are 7-6. So even in the blocker category, so Kallio doing a good job keeping their blockers on the track, perhaps leading to these strong power kills that we've seen. And it looks like we're going to have Bazooka Bubblegum getting another opportunity on the Fast Girl State start line with the star for Dallas. It's getting up against Picante with her first jam of the game for Kallio.
Bazooka Bubblegum with lead and 4 points her first time out. Nice acceleration. Takes a little whip off her own blocker. Gets lead jammer. Not out of the pack first, but big acceleration by Bazooka Bubblegum. An attempted call off by Picante. She thought she was lead. Answer is no, you are not. And now Bazooka Bubblegum continues to accelerate around. She's racing for points. Big hit by Mona Bruiser, knocking Picante to the ground. Picante discussing things with her bench, but telling them she is not a lead jammer. And those that belongs to Bazooka Bubblegum, who just picked up 4 points, Nerd.
And Mona Bruiser continuing to deliver some big hits. Maybe not a more fitting number than her 9-1-1, the way she delivers that shoulder.
Bazooka Bubblegum making the best of her time on the track. Did not get the play in the first game, but jamming with aplomb in game number two.
And such speed, kind of like a little cannonball out there, just bursting through those braced walls of Kallio. Kallio now trying to straighten things up on the wall, and it did work as they cut off those lanes.
That was Teabag with a nice bump out and draw back. 4 points get picked up by Picante. Bazooka Bubblegum probably going to have to call this jam off. We'll see if the bench wants to. Yeah, she's going to. See how many points she picked up before it disappeared. No additional points, but still a successful jam for Dallas.
9-4, killed a few more minutes off that clock now. 82-16 is the score, 12 minutes to go. The WF Today would like to thank 5-on-5 Magazine, Rollline, Bruce Skate News, and RollerGirl.ca, who of course is sponsoring our timeouts, and we have had none of those yet this game.
Not a single one, and that's why the clock has been flying in this first half. Pretty sick taking the star on the Fast Girl start line. She'll go up against Anita Riot. Anita Riot working her way through. Pretty sick. Quick drawback, quick re-entry. Now trying to work that outside magic one more time. But the wall of the Army of Darkness reforms the two wall to the outside, bumped by the pivot Bailey Wheat. And that allows Blakely to reform. Now that two wall becomes a tripod. Much more dangerous by Dallas. And the hops on the toe stops are going to result in a track cut. Wonder if Dallas was watching Nerd the first game and saw the tendency of her to try that.
Yeah, fifth jammer penalty now for the Kallio All Colors, and pretty sick herself is sitting on three trips to the box of those six.
So Anita Riot now on a power jam for the Army of Darkness, picks up lead jammer status. Kallio was able to hold her back for 50 seconds. They did kill a good chunk of the 30-second penalty. Pretty sick still in the penalty box, though, as she comes around and re-engages the pack. Lots of assistance from the blockers. Great work by Planet of the Skates, opening up the inside, pushing to the out. And 5 quick points for Anita Riot, coming around for more.
Pretty sick now, standing in the box less than 10 seconds in her penalty. And you will see her now come into the left of your screen as she re-enters the pack.
Nice drawback by Bailey Wheat on Pretty Sick, making her go a little bit further. And now it's a four-wall, nice bridge by Planet of the Skates to keep everything in play. A little bit of tiredness being shown on the face of Anita Riot, looking over at her bench to see if she's done enough. The answer is no, keep on going. You got 22 seconds more. A forearm penalty is going to send to the box, Doomy behind. And Anita Riot spins to the outside. She will take another 5 points for the Army of Darkness.
Nice little fake offense there from Planet of the Skates, just kind of standing in amongst the Kallio blockers. And that allowed... And then allowed Anita Riot to take the outside. Tried to jump on the inside there. Not as much success on that pass, and no points on that.
No, that was Machu Picchu that had the hip But that was a long distance she was trying to jump, Nerd.
Absolutely. Under 10 now to go in this opening half. As you mentioned, it's blown by. 92-16 is the substantial lead. Kallio has only put points on the board on three jams so far. And on the other side, Dallas has only been held scoreless on one jam. And now we finally have our first rollergirl.ca timeout being taken by the Kallio All Colors. Probably a good time as Dallas has really extended this lead now.
Yeah, and I mean, Kallio had problems with using up all of their stoppages in their first game, but, you know, in this, that game remained fairly close most of the way through. This game is not close, and you need to have that reset. Jammer penalties, they just have not been able to adapt to this track.
Nope, once again, five jammer penalties so far this game. They've been really keeping their blockers on the track very nicely, have played a very clean game. Actually, right now, probably on pace to be a little bit below their 25 jammer blocker penalties a game that they averaged in the regular season. So a really nice discipline in the pack. And it's just keeping those jammers in. And you did talk about how Pretty Sick, for example, likes to take those lines and kind of dance right on the edge. And it can work. When it works, it's unbelievable. But when it doesn't and when a team is ready for it, you can get drawn into those track cuts, which we've seen so far. Four jams for Pretty Sick, three jammer penalties.
And that makes it tough when one of your top scorers is getting in penalty trouble nonstop. I mean, they had two of them going that way yesterday against Rocky Mountain, but just one against Dallas is enough, as Dallas has stretched this lead to large proportions. 76 points separating the team's Fast Girl start line as we get action underway with 9 minutes and 25 seconds remaining. It's going to be Miley Virus going up against Sarah Gilbert. Sarah Gilbert's fourth jam of this half. 4 points scored so far. Miley Virus finds the gap. She's going to be lead again.
3 for 3 now for Miley Virus. 100% lead percentage on 27 points on her three jams.
Now already around, bumps into the back of Valhalla as the Kallio Rolling Rainbow quad pod looks to hold up. Out the front with a star stash is Sarah Gilbert, so we'll be able to limit the damage as long as Dallas doesn't decide to run this. Miley Virus, hands on hips, 4 points are going to get put up in the air.
Miley Virus right now sitting on just about a 9 points, or just over 10 points per jam now, which unbelievably actually matches her season average of 10.15 points per jam. She's sitting on that perfectly right now.
That's right. Game. Yeah, I mean, I was very impressed when we looked at the stats book. It's like 10 points a jam. I mean, she didn't play that many games, but she, those are big points.
Yeah, that was on 264 points. Had a 77% lead percentage during the regular season, and that high level of play had continued here this weekend.
Jet quickly through on the inside, little sidestep. Also getting out is Layla Gay, so I suspect we'll have ourselves a quick little jam. Pack tries to position itself. Jet makes sure that a point is available for is available as she quickly goes through, grabs two. Nice work at the back by the Dallas blockers.
Now 8 minutes to go here in opening half. You're watching WFTDA.TV's continuing coverage of the 2016 International WFTDA Division I Playoffs live here at Centre Pierre Charbonneau. I'm the Derby Nerd with Captain Lou. And we are watching Consolation Showdown between Dallas in the black, Kallio All Colors in the white. The winner moves on to face Detroit in the Consolation semifinal with an opportunity to eventually play for fifth place.
That'll be at 8 p.m. tonight. Bazooka Bubblebum taking the star for the third time in this game. 2 for 2 so far. Picante gets the star for Kallio. She's up at the front and the inside opened up for her. She's going to get lead jammer for Kallio.
Huge pickup for Kallio. The first in five jams and only the third of the game so far for the All Colors.
Animal Lee with a big hit on Teabag, but that allows Picante to get past her and pick up her points. Another bump by Animal Lee, but Picante now working her way through the pack, looking to pick up a scoring pass, as still stuck in the group is Bazooka Bubblebum. Bazooka Bubblebum having to be recycled one more time.
Nice shot there of that grueling Dallas defense, but now coming in to work some offense is Mischief, and she did separate them.
But it goes from tripod to all of a sudden there's single blockers absolutely decimating you, and then they reform in front of you. It seems so unfair. Seems like there's more than four blockers on the track at a time. Picante cannot hold the inside or the outside line. She's going to have to go all the way back. But again, she is lead jammer, and Bazooka Bubblebum has not completed her initial pass. So plenty of time for Picante to continue to work. Direction of gameplay is going to send Animal Lee to the penalty box. The offense is now gone for Bazooka Bubblebum.
You bring up a good point, though, about Dallas and the strength of their packs. They work so well in four, they work so well in three, and even as duos, just such strong walls they can build.
Schlageloff with a high block to the penalty box. That makes a little bit more room out there for Bazooka Bubblebum. She gets out. Picante will take 4 points and has to call it off. Great defense by Dallas, even though they lost Picante first pass through.
We will be pivotless to start off this next jam. 3-3 in the pack. There's one each in the box. It's going to be Sarah Gilbert on the Fast Girls start line, and she'll be facing off against Acute Pain. Acute Pain had a nice 60% lead percentage against Montreal last night. Converted that into 19 points on a 3.8 points per jam.
Yeah, she was kind of a relief jammer last night, but did a great job in relief.
Yeah, she did. Just behind Sparrow Dynamic, was actually their fourth jammer really last night.
Sarah Gilbert pushing hard at the front, bumping up against Blakely and Nick's victim, valiantly trying to hold her to the inside, knock her down. That allows Bailey Wheat to come up and provide some support as well. Out of the penalty box comes Schlageloff, quickly into the formation. Out of the penalty box also Animal Lee, who immediately goes into offensive mode. The pivot on pivot blocking going on in the back of the pack. Is working her way through Acute Pain, trying to find the gaps that Animal Lee is trying to provide her at the front. It's just a straight up grind. It's a two wall, one inverted, one regular direction, and now all of a sudden it turns into a tripod as the backpack had gone forward enough that the bridge was no longer required. Now Sarah Gilbert is absolutely at a standstill, nerd.
Unbelievable defense here from both teams, but Sarah Gilbert being called now on a high block, a shoulder to the face, so that will send her to the penalty box. Fifth power jam now opportunity, or make that sixth power jam opportunity for Dallas. I've lost count, Captain Lou.
Sarah Gilbert looking absolutely dejected as she went to the penalty box, picking up that second penalty. She was working so hard at the front of the pack, and then contact with above the shoulders sat her down for 30 seconds. A little blocker push. Forearm penalty is going to send that blocker to the penalty box, but lead jammer is going to go to Acute Pain. Nice work, though, on the part of Nick's victim.
90 seconds it took for Acute Pain to get through and pick up lead jammer status. It's a great defense from Kallio, and they're going to need to continue that here on the power kill, although it has come to a very quick end, or 30 seconds. It just seemed quick, but back now on the track is Sarah Gilbert.
Acute Pain through the pack, picks up 5 points. Nice work on the jammer from the Army of Darkness. Dallas doing great work on both offense and defense in this game.
Absolutely. It's going to be one in the box to start off this next jam, so Kallio will have a 4-3 pack advantage as Nick's victim is standing, so less than 10 seconds to go. Dallas has picked up 10 leads in the 15 jams so far. Of course, we had one jam go the full two without a lead given. So Dallas dominating, continuing to dominate off the start, but that was so heartbreaking, that last jam. Kallio playing so well on the defense, and Sarah Gilbert had the front of that pack, and just a shoulder just slipped up in that grind.
Anita Riott taking the star. Layla Gay for the all colors. Layla Gay at the front of the pack loses her footing once again. The sport court coming to haunt the all colors. Penalty being called. That takes Mona Bruiser to the penalty box, and getting out of the pack first is Layla Gay. Right behind her is Anita Riott. Be interesting to see if Kallio decides to run this. They are down 103 to 20. Not going to do it. But at that point in time, nerd, it's the time to run some jams.
Yeah, you'd think so with only 2:20 left in the half. And as you mentioned, down by a fairly significant margin now. They were never close to being down this much yesterday against Rocky Mountain. It might be time to start trying to stretch things out and get some points on the board as we go into halftime. Official review has been called. This official review is brought to you by rollergirl.ca, Canada's skate shop. Experience Canadian customer service. Go to rollergirl.ca.
And, you know, Kallio's made some mistakes in this game, but really, I mean, the reality of the situation is Dallas is just playing another phenomenal game. And they played a great game against Montreal. They were very clean. Montreal also very clean in that game. They're playing another very clean game in this game. Penalties matter, both jammer and blocker penalties.
Yeah, absolutely. And again, the jammer penalties just so despairingly in favor of Dallas. Dallas has yet to send a jammer to the penalty box. And that's going to make a huge difference.
You can see the whiteboard on the screen right there. Only 12 trips to the penalty box for Dallas. You would think that that is a low number compared to their penalties yesterday. They actually only took 17 penalties in that Montreal game. So
Kallio is looking for a cut on the jammer on that last jam. That has been the requested review.
That's a decent use of an official review at with 2 minutes and 21 seconds, regardless of whether you actually believe there was a cut. It's a good stoppage of the clock.
Yep, and it's already stretched into a minute and 30. So that's why I wonder sometimes when people turn their official reviews into a timeout, you might be able to stretch a few extra seconds out of there if you actually do try and make a review.
That's right. If you really need a rest or if you're just trying to stop the clock, you know. But, yeah, if you've got the gift of the gab, you can go out there. I can talk for a minute all by myself before I even get my question finished.
That's right. Give your skater an opportunity to get some rest. Kallio is going to look to strengthen their position here leading into halftime, down by 83 points. And it looks like the no call is going to stand. So Kallio will not get a power jam out of that one. But they did get a two-minute break, some rest, and they're going to go back with Pretty Sick on the fast girl skate start line. She's going to skate against leading scorer Miley Virus, who continues to lead her team. And she is sitting now on actually second in scoring right now on her team. Anita Riott has pulled ahead 32 to Miley Virus's 31.
Single point's not that much, so it's all right.
Statistically insignificant
exactly.
Is that difference.
Drawback on Pretty Sick, who is being very cautious now in this jam with those three penalties she's picked up already in this game. Miley Virus throwing herself once more into that tripod. Dumi behind. Machu Picchu KO doing a great job of holding Miley Virus back, pinning her to the inside. That allows Pretty Sick to accelerate the wall of Dallas through that gap that was forced by the all colors blockers, and with only one to beat, she gets around Blakely and lead jammer for Pretty Sick.
And coming out of the penalty box is Mona Bruiser, and she did supply enough offense to free Miley Virus from the pack.
Great work shifting from D to O, straight into the offense from the penalty box. Pretty Sick gets the hands on the hip. 1 point wanted by Miley Virus. She's going to grab it, and they're 2-1 in that jam.
A little bit of a steal there, but that is three lead jammers out of the last four jams now for Kallio. That is their best and most consistent run here of the first half. So momentum shifting a bit into Callio's favor, even if we don't see those results on the scoreboard just yet. But success is coming their way. And so if they can maintain this, they're going to start seeing those points go up onto the board. Official timeout called here.
Yeah, umpire strikes back, heading over to chat with the Kallio bench.
Something there that he didn't like. That was a nice overhead shot of this sport court. Sport court supplied by Gotham Girls Roller Derby this weekend for
driven
Montreal.
Driven up from New York City to Montreal.
And here's a little bit of a nerd stat. I believe this is the same sport court that was laid out in Yonge Dundas Square in Toronto in 2009 for the world debut of Whip It at the Toronto International Film Festival.
Where some of the Toronto roller skaters participated.
Yes, that's right.
Yes, indeed. That is a lovely, lovely bit of... Yes, you are proving once again exactly why you are called the Derby Nerd.
All right. Speaking of Derby, back on the Fast Girl Skate start line, Jet is going to be jamming this one. She'll be up against Picante. Picante out there for the third time, used sparingly in this game as a bit of relief from Kallio's primary jammers.
Whistle blown, Jet to the inside, Picante to the outside, but nice lateral movement spreads out the defense, and that makes room for Jet, skips her way out. First jammer out means you're a lead jammer, and therefore she is a lead jammer.
And comes spinning around at turn number one, tapping her hips in through for four. So it looks like the referee was just giving warning to the teams about leading with the head. And as we've seen, these grinding packs, they get lower and lower, and skaters' heads start to get down, and they start to push with them a little bit. So umpire strikes back, decided to give a little bit of warning to the benches.
Yeah, then the exhaustion factor as well. I mean, mm-hmm. we're on day two, teams starting to get pretty tired. It's still early enough in the day. Probably the last jam of this half. Anita Riott does the honors for Dallas. It's going to be Sarah Gilbert for Kallio. Sarah Gilbert once again stymied at the back by the Army of Darkness blockers. Nice transition from defense into offense by Bailey Wheat. Spins around from the outside to try to crack the wall. And she opens up enough of a gap. And that's the difference in this game, not just the jammer penalties. Anita Riott getting offensive help and getting out first.
Yeah, absolutely. Dallas, again, just so confident in their ability to hold and to maintain that once they lock in with three blockers, they very quickly send that fourth up to play offense.
Star pass to Matthew Bitchu. Forced the call off. No time going to be left in this half. 5 points, 4 points scored in that last jam. 112-22, a dominating performance by the Dallas Derby Devils, the Army of Darkness coming in, and they do not want to finish in the 9-10 game, and they have thrown down the gauntlet early. That gauntlet was mishandled multiple times by Kallio in that first half with all those penalties, Nerd.
Absolutely was. Dallas picking up, as you mentioned earlier, right where they left off last night. Had such a strong quarterfinal showdown and a loss to Montreal. It looks like they were not at all discouraged by that and have come out with the same level of defense, that same OD transitions, and they look very strong in this one, looking to set up that consolation showdown against Detroit tonight at 8 p.m.
Yeah, I mean, if you win this game, you get to play four games this weekend. You lose this game, you only get three. You want to make sure that your weekend is as valuable as possible. Once again, you are watching the 2016 International WFTDA Division I Playoff live from Montreal, Quebec, Canada. Dallas versus Kallio, 112-22. Dallas in the lead for Captain Lou Albamo and the Derby Nerd. We're going to take a break at halftime. Come on back to WFTDA.tv. And welcome back to the 2016 International WFTDA Division I Playoffs live from Montreal, Quebec, Canada. This is, of course, the Dallas Derby Devils taking on the Kallio All Colors. Dominating first half performance, Captain Lou Albamo, Derby Nerd. Let's talk a bit about that first half.
Yeah, a very interesting first half. Penalties were just about even, 13-13 in terms of blocker penalties. Yeah. But, of course, the one disparity was in the amount of jammer penalties that Kallio picked up, which was six.
Zero for Dallas.
And zero for Dallas. You're taking a look at the whiteboard there. So pretty clean game in terms of the blocker penalties, right on par for Kallio. A little above the season average for Dallas, but nonetheless a very clean game in the pack. And that's led to some good grinding battles that we've seen out there on the track.
It has. And we don't want to focus on the negatives, so we'll look at the positives that Dallas has been putting out there. And we're just seeing a lot of what top 20 teams in the WFTDA have been able to put out there. Just that transition from defense to bridging, then the bridge throws into offense, and then transitions back to a bridge or goes back into defense. And they're just showing that they're operating at a very elite level.
Yeah, absolutely. And also they're able to function when that foursome does break up. So if they only have three blockers, they're very strong together, two as well. It really does look like they do practice with every single formation to make sure that they're ready for any situation they're presented with on the track.
Yeah, and I certainly know, having called the D2s last weekend in Lansing, Michigan, you saw Bear City had decent ability to drop into those different formations, but a lot of the teams, you can see that they focus solely on either the tripod or the four wall that continues to be braced, and you're spending all your time on that one formation when all these other formations, you need the time to work on them as well.
Yeah, absolutely. And especially look at the Dallas two walls when they get together. They usually have one facing in each direction, and they kind of come together like two little puzzle pieces, and they're really hard to split apart.
On the Kallio side, well, their defense has held strong, but it's the jammer penalties that are making life difficult for them one more time.
Yeah, absolutely. As we mentioned, 6 jammer penalties, 3 going to Pretty Sick. One good bit of news, though, is Sarah Gilbert, who ran into some early penalty troubles against Rocky Mountain, sitting only on 2 penalties. Unfortunately, she hasn't been able to convert that into a big scoring run, sitting only on 4 points. She is, of course, overwhelming the leading scorer for the Kallio Rolling Rainbow, so they're going to need to get her going here in the second half.
So as time ticks down in halftime, the score remains at 112-22, a 90-point lead for the Army of Darkness. The winner will move on to play Detroit later tonight at 8 p.m. The loser will play Sun State tomorrow at the 10 a.m. game, 9th and 10th place at stake there.
And just a little bit of an update. There was an official review called at the end of that first half. Dallas wanted to use up their review, and they wanted a blocking with the head on the Kallio jammer. But it looks like the no call will stand. So we mentioned earlier that the teams had been warned about leading with the head, and so Dallas was testing that warning. But for on this occasion, anyway, the call will stand. So Dallas lost their official review in the final seconds of the opening half.
But we'll see if that sort of draws the awareness of the, I mean, obviously the referees were already noticing it, or they wouldn't have put out the warning, but asking it for the official review as well, see if there's a heightened focus on the blocking with the head penalty in the second half.
Leading scorers so far for the game, Anita Riot leading all scorers and also leading the way, obviously, for Dallas with 36 points on 6 jams. On the other side of the board, Picante and Pretty Sick both sitting on 8 points, though I'd like to point out Picante has scored all 8 of those very efficiently in only 3 jams. Picante also leading the way with a 33% lead percentage, picking up, no jammer has picked up more than 1 lead on the Kallio side of the board.
Penalty box will start with, looks like Bailey Wheat in the penalty box for, no, that is Nick's victim in the penalty box wearing the pivot stripe for Dallas, and it is Dumi behind for Kallio, so 3-on-3 pack when we get action underway.
Nick's victim, the only blocker in the game with more than 3 penalties. She is sitting currently on her 4th penalty. Start off the second half here.
But again, she has been a nice highlight in this game. That has not played 11 jams and is one of those transitioners. Goes from offense to defense to defense to offense to bridge, and high activity. So that's she's in the danger zone because she's doing a lot of things when she's on the track. So yes, pivot Bailey Wheat, Blakely and Planet of the Skates will be in front of Anita Riot, and it's going to be Watuvima, Machu Picchu and KO in front of Leila Gay as the second half gets underway. Dallas leading 112-22, 30 more minutes of action to ensue.
And already knocked out and dragged back, so the Dallas defense off to a hot start here in the second half.
And the Kallio defense cannot keep Anita Riot in the pack. She is free and in the open spaces now, back around the track and ready to close through. Oh, quick little break of the arm brace. No multiplayer black called because she was not held up, and she grabs a quick four nerd.
A Doomy behind coming out of the penalty box, followed very quickly by Nick's victim. So we're going to have 5-on-5 to kick off this second jam. But before we get there, we'd like to remind you that when you need to roll quick, think quick. Quick Bearings, where precision meets performance. Quick, part of the Rydell family.
On the fast girl start line, number 72, Pretty Sick. 3 penalties in the first half. See if she has adjusted her outside line game. She'll go up against Miley Virus. Miley Virus coming through the front. The Kallio blockers getting pushed around as well by Hannah Babarek. Hannah Babarek then drops into that bridge. Now Miley Virus is on her own. The pack comes close enough. Miley Virus now has assistance again from Hannah Babarek, and the drawback on Pretty Sick forces her way back to the start. An attempted apex jump ends up being failed. Blocking out of bounds penalty, though, being called a Mona Bruiser.
Must have just stepped out there at turn number 1 as she delivered that hit on the leaping Pretty Sick.
40 seconds expired in the jam. Neither jammer able to get through. Now, finally, through for Dallas is Miley Virus.
And that pumps her lead percentage up to 80% now. 4 leads in the 5 jams for Miley Virus. 32 points in the opening half.
Pretty Sick also escaping from the pack and now approaching the back. 4 points going to be snagged by Miley Virus. A low block being called on Animal Lee. And Pretty Sick was briefly worried that it might have been on her, but back onto the track, continuing to look to score points for Kallio. Returning to the track, Mona Bruiser, two blockers, continuing to bridge things out for Dallas until the reinforcements come. Pretty sick, being stymied one more time. Dallas losing another blocker to the penalty box.
Yeah, Dallas running into some early blocker penalty trouble here in the second half. That is going to be Hanna-Barbera now in the box just as the pivot Anna Malie stands. Less than 10 seconds to go, and she'll be back on the track.
Mona Bruiser with two rotations on Pretty Sick, but couldn't keep her in there. She will take the 4 points. Three more points given up by Kallio. 7-4 in that jam.
123-26 now, 3 minutes in. And did you know that in addition to helmets, S1 now makes pads for Roller Derby 2? Make S1 part of your uniform. Find out more at S1helmets.com. Also like to take this opportunity on behalf of WFTDA Montreal Roller Derby to thank Neon Skates, Nerd Skates, and Team Canada Roller Derby.
On the fast girl start line, Bazooka Bubble Bum for the first jam of her second half, but it's going to be Picante through on the inside lead jammer for Kallio All Colors.
50% lead jammer status now for Picante, so she has done excellent work in very limited opportunities. Look to see more of her as the second half continues.
A tripod of doom pushing Picante out of bounds, drawback by Bailey Wheat. Picante looking to reset, having trouble even finding room to get her arms on her hips.
Three more points on the board for Picante now, 11 in four jams, and has now moved into second, just behind Pretty Sick in the scoring for the Kallio All Colors. And you know, some guy named Dave Miller has written a book. Yeah, it's called Eight Wheeled Freedom. You can find out more about it online at eightwheeledfreedom.com or at any good bookstore, and maybe even some mediocre ones as well.
If you look in the back, you can find a picture of that handsome devil. Next jam starts with Leila Gay wearing the star for the All Colors. It's Jet, number 5 for Dallas Derby Devils, and Jet working away through the front of the pack. Two inverted blockers trying to hold Jet back, and the pack sort of reabsorbs her. She almost was free, but now it's a tripod forming up and almost a quad pod as the pivot Schlagerloff is now bridging and blocking. Out of bounds penalty on Jet, the first jammer penalty of the half, Derby Nerd.
Yeah, and first
of the game.
Yeah, of the game for Dallas. So Jet heading to the penalty box. Kallio All Colors with their first power jam of this consolation quarterfinal showdown. Let's see if they can take advantage of it. But Dallas right now locking down the defense on the penalty kill. Mischief trying to work some offense.
Kallio trailing by almost triple digits in this game. The Kallio blockers just looking for the right time to make their move, but Dallas Derby Devil blockers absorb those hits in quick reformation one more time, and suddenly that quad pod is right back in front. Nice bridge work, allowing the blockers to continue to block. Only one to beat. Mona Bruiser can't get a hip on her, and Leila Gay gets lead jammer status.
Took 1 minute and 15 seconds for Leila Gay to get through, and that minute and 15 took out all of the penalty on Jet. So power jam is over. No damage done. Great defense, Dallas.
Valhalla, the last blocker to try to stop Jet, will not contain her in the pack. See if Leila Gay decides to call it off. Indication from the bench is yes. There goes the hands, and two more points for Kallio.
So not a bad start here to the second half for Kallio. 9 points to 11 here early on in the second half. So the keeping pace with Dallas, 6 minutes in to the second period. On the fast girl skate start line, it's going to be acute pain for Dallas in the black, squaring off against Sarah Gilbert in the white for the Kallio All Colors.
Sarah Gilbert still at 4 points in this game. Acute pain with 18 points. Jam underway. Acute pain takes the inside line, goes around Planet of the Skates, who then throws herself in for offense. She's an underappreciated blocker.
Mm-hmm.
She's been doing great. And a nice little blocker on blocker knockout and a drawback on Dumi behind. And Sarah Gilbert looking for some assistance from that blocker, hoping that she'll get some offense. And suddenly Sarah Gilbert is pushing through and going to get out first. Planet of the Skates a little stop. And Nick's victim unable to keep her in there either. So Sarah Gilbert with that last little burst, with that little bit of assistance from Doomy behind, able to get out first, Nerd.
And Planet of the Skates heading to the penalty box on a track cut. So Dallas losing a blocker there. It looks like Jammer coming in hot. Big collision. That's going to be a back block penalty on Sarah Gilbert. So Sarah Gilbert heading to the penalty box, her third trip in this game.
And Bailey Wheat really went down to the sport court very hard at the end of that. She has now taken the star pass. We will go the full 2 minutes as Sarah Gilbert was your lead jammer. 55 seconds to go. And your new jammer for this jam is Bailey Wheat, knocked out of bounds by Machu Picchu. Drawback in effect. She's rotated from turn four to turn three. Now trying to work her way through again. Nice pin to the inside by the blockers of Dallas. Opens up that gap, and through for five is Bailey Wheat.
Sarah Gilbert only had 7 penalties all regular season in the 4 games, and she's already got 9 here in 2.
Vatuvima's touch on Bailey Wheat was not enough to knock her out of bounds, and she rotated her way out of the pack for 5. Power jam over Sarah Gilbert through the pack, picks up her first points of this jam, and Bailey Wheat one more time skating out of the pack backwards, looking back at the people trying to stop her. She'll take another 4. Sarah Gilbert knocked down to the outside. Sarah Gilbert saying that she's being hit in the face. It's just going to be a direction of gameplay going to Blakely. Penalty will be called, though. 4 more points for Kallio, 1 more for Dallas. 15-8 in that jam.
Yeah, very messy jam there. But Dallas coming up on top once again with a 7-point advantage now, 8.5 minutes in. And it's going to be a slight pack advantage here for Kallio, 4-3. As this jam gets underway and on the fast girl skate start line, it's going to be acute pain. Acute pain sitting on 33 points on a 25% lead percentage. And she is up against
Picante. Got it now. Jam underway. Kallio choosing to start it at the pivot line and seeing if that would aid their jammer in getting through the tripod by the Army of Darkness. The answer is no, as Picante has knocked out of bounds and is now getting drawn back to where she started the jam at the front of the pack. It is Anita Riot jamming for the Army of Darkness, and Anita Riot getting some assistance by Blakely. Blakely looking back to make sure no pack destruction will happen, but a bump out by Teabag. Now Mischief draws back Anita Riot. So neither jammer having much luck so far as the jam continues to grind its way forward. The pack becoming increasingly spread out. Out of play indicated at the back on Teabag. Teabag moves forward to make sure she doesn't pick up a penalty. Blakely heading to the penalty box, and two left at the front by Dallas, trying to hold back Picante.
That's Blakely's second penalty of this jam. And just over a minute in, and we've just now made it to the back stretch.
And finally, through a little bit of acceleration down the straightaway, is Anita Riot, lead jammer for the Army of Darkness. Picante still having no luck, drawn back one more time. Animal Lee doing the job there, and it is 5 points put on the board by Anita Riot for the Dallas Derby Devils. Picante, one to beat, going to get passed.
Initial pass complete. This is the most adversity we've seen Picante suffer through thus far this game, having a strong performance so far for Kallio. And should take this opportunity to thank Adam Skates. You can check out the new pilot plate in 7 stunning colors, and you can see that at adamskates.com. And since we have a moment, WFTA would like to thank, of course, our hosts, Montreal Roller Derby, but also Derby Central, RollerCon, Spank Alley, and Cohen Law Offices.
Dallas Derby Devils with a 105-point lead as on the fast girl start line. Is acute pain this time? Nope. It is Miley Virus and Layla Gay. Miley Virus through first, lead jammer. Layla Gay quickly out after. Miley Virus about half a track to give. Miley Virus coming around turn 2, quickly into that pack, looking to pick off skaters in white and rainbows. Calls it off, and she had 2, nerd.
Just in time as Layla Gay was advancing on that pack quickly. And another pickup there for Miley Virus brings her total up to 41 points in this game. And 83% lead percentage for Miley Virus, picking up right where she left off last night. And indeed, what wait for she has been all regular season, leading her team both in lead percentage and scoring.
Fast Girl start line. We'll see Jet going up against Pretty Sick as Kallio once again takes the pivot line. It is where their bench is located, so I guess they are finding it easier to set up there. And Pretty Sick gets a little bit more room to move. Doesn't have to use that toe stop on the outside line to get through this time. Blasts her way through for lead jammer status. Still stuck in the pack is Jet. Jet now looking to move through on the inside. Bump to the inside. Having to reset one more time. Pretty Sick working against Animal Lee. Animal Lee trying to keep herself in front. Animal Lee bolstering the defense at the front as it turns into a tripod. And Jet, again, having trouble getting through at the back of the pack. The Rolling Rainbow doing a great job of holding back the jammer from the Dallas Derby Devils.
This is Kallio's fourth lead jammer status of the half. They actually have the advantage over Dallas 4-3 to start off the second half. But again, have not been able to make up much of the gap on the scoreboard despite the more success they're having in terms of the lead percentage.
Hanna-Barbera goes from bridge to offense, trying to free Jet. Jet still having no luck as the blockers from Kallio continue to pin her to the outside. Jet resets to the outside, now back to the inside. Still, there are skaters in white wherever she moves. Pretty Sick also being held up by skaters wearing black and red from the Dallas Derby Devils. And she has been unable to complete this scoring pass. Tumbled to the ground by Mona Bruiser. Mona Bruiser also resets herself, and that tripod reforms once again, Nerd.
An absolutely great defense here once again from both these teams. And we're seeing some good bridging from Kallio as well in this one, with Schlagerloff going up and down with the bridge and the offense. So Kallio adjusting and maybe picking up some tips from Dallas's gameplay.
The Jet got out after a minute and 35 seconds, forcing that call off, Nerd.
And that is not the first time we've seen that this game at all. We've had some grinding starts. We even had a full two-minute jam in the opening half without a lead jammer named. And there you can see Pretty Sick heading back to the bench. The results of that grinding defensive play we're seeing from both of these packs.
I mean, 95 seconds of just getting beaten up in the pack. Next jam on the way, Bazooka Bubblebum gets the star for Dallas. She'll go up against Sarah Gilbert. Sarah Gilbert looking for space on the outside, tries to wedge her way out. Bazooka Bubblebum follows the same path and finds gap on the outside, but then is swallowed back up by the pack. Sarah Gilbert picks up a track cut and right back to the penalty box, Nerd.
And second penalty of the half for Sarah Gilbert. Those are the only two jammer penalties we've seen, though, from Kallio. And that gives her, of course, as you mentioned, four on the game in only eight jams.
Machu Picchu waving at Bazooka Bubblebum to come at her, and she did, got through, picked up lead, and now has an opportunity to pick up points on this power jam.
That's the third lead jammer status for Bazooka Bubblegum. Bring her up to 60% for the game.
Bazooka Bubblebum looking where she is, out of bounds. And a back block on Bazooka Bubblebum will send her to the penalty box. That will release Sarah Gilbert, who is already standing in the penalty box. She'll return to the track. We've got 1 minute left in this jam, and we will go all 60 seconds as Sarah Gilbert returns to the track and has to go the long way around as jammer, Dallas, yeah.
Jammer penalties now equal 2-2 here in the second half. Obviously very different from the first half, so nice adjustments here from Kallio.
Bailey Wheat with that long, long drawback, wearing the pivot star, a pivot stripe for Dallas. Planet of the Skates doing a great job with Nick's victim at the front of the pack. Bazooka Bubblebum is returning to the track. Planet of the Skates to the penalty box on a high block. Now it's one-on-one blocking with Nick's victim. Gets three hits in on Sarah Gilbert, but Sarah Gilbert gets out on her initial pass.
That second penalty of the game for Planet of the Skates.
Bazooka Bubblebum looking to, hey, there's Sarah Gilbert scuffing through on the inside. She'll take 4 points. Bazooka Bubblebum has taken the star off. And the pivot, Bailey Wheat holding her bottom of her face, her throat as she tumbles to the ground. Slow. Hard hit.
Yeah, slow to get up. It does seem to be okay. And once again, seeing Sarah Gilbert heading back to the bench on your screen. A grueling game here for the Jammers, as the defense has been strong from both of these teams. Doesn't feel like a 100-point difference between these two teams, because Kallio has really adjusted well and are having a very strong second half compared to their first. And this is something that we saw yesterday as well, Captain Lou, against Rocky Mountain. Was Kallio off to a slow start, makes those adjustments, but just doing so a little bit late in the game.
Right, and we talk about Kallio being a new team, but they're a new team to the playoffs.
Yeah.
I mean, they've been around for a while. They're fairly new to the Wftda as well. Mm-hmm. But these are learning tournaments for teams. A lot of times their first experience here. You come in and you want to come in and perform really well, but there's so much going on at these tournaments, so many different styles, the officiating, the track surface. There's so many adjustments you have to make. It's not easy to perform at 100%.
No, absolutely. When you haven't played on a lot of different kinds of surfaces, it's harder to adjust to any surface. But you have mentioned Kallio has been around. They did form in 2010 as Helsinki's second team, and of course have been members of the Wftda since July 2014. Talking about adjustments, this half scoring, slight advantage for Dallas, but certainly nothing like we saw over the first half of the first half. Dallas leading 34-26 here in the second half. So Kallio with a strong performance here in the second period.
4-on-3 pack advantage for Kallio as we get the game back underway. 13 minutes, 23 seconds remaining, at about 146-48 to score. Dallas leading over Kallio. And on the fast girl start line will be Miley Virus going up against Picante. Picante stuffed at the back of the pack by the tripod of Dallas and just trying to push her way through. Planet of the Skates comes out of the penalty box and immediately into offense, trying to open things up for Miley Virus. Miley Virus at the front of the pack. Now Planet of the Skates looking to see, does she need to keep bridging or can she go on offense? Miley Virus looking back, perhaps wishing to have a bit of offense of help as well. Animal Lee heading the penalty box, and now Planet of the Skates has to drop back and join the two blockers at the back. That is Guillotine Grace and Mona Bruiser as they continue to stop Picante from moving forward.
And that was a great look at the Dallas defense and the way that they can adjust. Losing that blocker could have been a disaster for them, but they were able to reconnect so quickly, and Planet of the Skates, as you mentioned, just noticed that penalty and dropped back to help brace that two-all. And as you can see, they're holding Picante at turn two.
And Mischief doing a great job of holding up as the bridge, a low block being called on Guillotine Grace. That's going to get Picante out, but already with lead jammer status is Miley Virus. She's completing her circuit of the track, skipping her way through the pack. Not a lot of time to work as here comes Picante. Miley Virus tumbling to the ground. Might have wanted to call it off, but she's not going to have to, because she's got to do another circuit, 4 points a side nerd.
That's right, took that hit, and that allowed Picante just enough time to sneak through and get four. So Dallas going to try and get on top of this jam before they call it off.
Teabag picking up a low block as that tumble that forced Miley Virus to the ground. Through on the second scoring pass is Picante. Miley Virus wanting to match that and skipping through on the outside. Nice seal off by Mona Bruiser, allowing her gap to get past the blockers of the All Colors. Jam continuing. Dallas has control of the clock. Picante back in the pack and scoring points. Miley Virus now back even with Picante. Passes her in the pack, tumbles to the ground, knocked down by Schlagerloff. Jam's going to come to its conclusion. 4 more points for Kallio.
Yeah, with this kind of lead, Dallas can take these risks and let Jams go long, and they can come out down by 4 and a 12-8, but knowing that they killed 2 more minutes off the clock, and they have a fairly substantial lead right now, 154-60, with 11 minutes to go. And we'd like to thank our start line sponsor, Fast Girl Skates. Fast Girl Skates, 9 years dedicated to making a faster you.
Yeah, I mean, that lead is not 100% safe with less than 11 minutes to go, but it's pretty decent at the moment, especially given the defense they've been able to show. Layla Gay jamming 4. Kallio and Anita Riot 4. Dallas and Anita Riot running up against Matthew Beechu on the outside. Matthew Beechu was inverted and kept her stopped, but then she reset to the inside. Forced her way through. Matthew Beechu pursued her all the way through the pack. Couldn't keep her in there, though. And now heads to the penalty box.
Yeah, picked up a forearm penalty on that. But impressive performance so far from Machu Picchu in both of these games. And I have a feeling this is not going to be the last time we see the Kallio All Colors in the playoffs. So this will be end up being a very, very valuable learning experience for them.
No pass, no penalty indicated on Anita Riot as she went out of bounds as a blocker. The knocked her out of bounds also went out, so no problem coming back in. Doesn't get the point, but does get through the pass. 4-0 in that jam. Finally out of the pack now is Layla Gay. Anita Riot approaching the back of the back again. Dumi behind forces her to the inside. Watuvima holds her back. Only 3 points picked up, but second pass, 7-0.
Under 10 minutes to go now in this consolation bracket showdown between Kallio All Colors and the Dallas Derby Devils. As you mentioned, Kallio in danger now of slipping into that last place game. That will be tomorrow at 10 a.m. on Championship Sunday. The winner moving on to play tonight at 8 p.m. And right now, anyway, it looks as if that will be Dallas.
And jamming away with Jet. Sliding across the back of that wall of white and finds a gap on the outside. Picks up a lead jammer. Pretty sick. Riding the hips of Guillotine Grace into the apex. And a back block's going to be picked up on Jet. We'll go with a full 2 minutes. It's pretty sick with a chance to do some damage here in this game, Nerd.
Yeah, third jammer penalty of the half for Dallas. So they now have more jammer penalties this half than Kallio does. Kallio just with the two.
Pretty sick, shrugs off a hit by Blakely, picks up the first 4 points of this power jam for Kallio, coming around on another scoring pass. Tripod is set up on the inside of the track, waiting to come back on as Hannah Barbaric, not wanting to draw the pack too far back. Now coming back on, Machu Picchu making friends with her, and Hannah Barbaric knocking down Mischief, trying to return to the Dallas Derby Devils. Pretty sick, coming around another scoring pass, bumped to the inside. Back block penalty will send the Animal lead to the penalty box. And out of the penalty box is Jet. Jet through on her first scoring pass. She'll take 4 points. Pretty sick. Looking a little bit tired at the front of the pack, Nerd.
Yeah, great job from Jet just to use that momentum to come through on the inside. Tried to do it again on the outside, but Kallio had smartened up to that, and a big hit from Teabag forces the reset by Jet all the way at turn two.
Yeah, Teabag got shoulder to shoulder. Basically, the feet kept going, but the top of the body did not, and that threw Jet to the ground straight to the sport court. Pretty sick getting some assistance from Machu Picchu. Still having trouble getting out. Guillotine Grace not able to keep her in bounds. Very strong on the outside. We've seen that from her. She's taken some steps wrong during this game and in the previous one. But when she wants to be strong on the outside and she has enough room to work with, very difficult to keep. Pretty sick.
Pretty sick now sitting on 32 points and already around quickly on that pass and looking for more. Picked up one more at the very end of that jam. But two put on the board at the end for Jet as well. That makes it a 16-6 jam for Kallio. So coming out by 10. And that brings their total up to 76 points with 7 minutes left to go. Coming up on the Fast Girl Skate start line now, Kallio looking to keep this momentum going. Picante will take on the star, having a strong game with 23 points and a 30% lead percentage. And be facing off against Acute Pain, who herself is sitting on 33 points on only a 20% lead percentage. We have a team timeout now called. This team timeout brought to you by rollergirl.ca, Canada's skate shop. Experience the Canadian dollar. Go to rollergirl.ca. And we talked a little bit about the history of Kallio, and I think people sometimes forget about how long Dallas Roller Derby has been around. Dallas Derby Devils, one of the WFTA's original teams.
Original members. We have tons of them at this tournament.
Absolutely.
Six out of ten.
Yeah. And then the other four are all internationally based or non-U.S. based teams.
That's right. We're
all international somewhere. Really interesting mix of teams here. Dallas actually formed in 2004, believe it or not, and began play in May 2005. And as we mentioned, an original member of the WFTDA. They came into this tournament with 68 lifetime victories in the WFTDA. Sanctioned victories, that is.
Sanctioned victories.
Yeah.
And they've really been a force over the last couple of years, just reformatting their defense has just given so much more opportunity for their offense, their jammers, to get through.
Yeah, they didn't make the playoffs last year in 2014 after being in the Division II in 2013 and making most of their opportunity here in the D1s in Montreal.
Acute Pain, Picante, the jammers up the right now, and it is Picante through first. Nearly fell to the ground, but staying on her skates allowed her momentum to push herself through that pack. Now coming through the inside, greeted harshly by Planet of the Skates, the quick drawback, almost drawing the cut on Picante, and now the pack goes in reverse. As Acute Pain also having to recycle. Picante on a scoring pass. The star is stashed for the Dallas Derby Devils, deciding whether or not she wants to pass it to Bailey Wheat or not. Going to the outside. And now looking to do the star's pass, and it is completed to Bailey Wheat. Second star pass of this game, but taken by Bailey Wheat. Very successful the first time through. See if what she does. Coming in hot. Forces the call off, Nerd.
Yeah, Picante was knocked to the inside there. Takes a look up. Did pick up a few points. 3 on that final pass. So good work from Picante once again. Moving into one of the primary jammer roles in this game, having some success against Dallas. Maybe it's that smaller but yet still strong build that's allowing her to get through these slightly bigger Dallas blockers. But seems like she's able to find those gaps a little bit better than some of the larger jammers on Kallio, like Pretty Sick and Sarah Gilbert are.
Next jam starts with Miley Virus going up against Sarah Gilbert. Sarah Gilbert trying to bull her way through the tripod. She's gotten part of it broken up. Blockers from the Armory of Darkness milling about, but they cannot get reformed in time. Sarah Gilbert picking up lead jammer for Kallio.
Very important lead jammer status, second in a row for Kallio.
Oh, a nice hip by Teabag, but she doesn't get Miley Virus out of bounds. Miley Virus picks herself up off of the flat track and keeps on skating. Gonna have forced a call off on Sarah Gilbert. 2 additional points taken by the All Colors.
That was only the second time Miley Virus has not picked up lead jammer status in this game. Roll faster, farther, and smoother with precision bearings from Quick. And while we're at it, let's say a few more thank yous. Big thanks to AAA, to Moda Skates, Double Threat Skates, and Chaya, and of course, S1. Big thank you on behalf of the WFTDA and Montreal Roller Derby.
Thank you to everyone sitting at home watching us on WFTDA.tv. We do appreciate your eyeballs. It's going to be Layla Gay and Anita Riot in this jam. Layla Gay drawn back, Anita Riot quick reset. At the front, Kallio getting separated by the blockers of Dallas. Anita Riot trying to push her way through on the outside, looking for a quick reset to the inside. Dumi behind follows her at the front. Layla Gay trying to find some way to wedge herself into the back wall of that tripod, quad pod of the Dallas Derby Devils. And now she's tumbled to the ground. A forearm penalty is going to get called. See who's getting sent. It's Blakely going to the penalty box.
Machu Picchu with some excellent work there, stopping the drag back from the Dallas blockers, and that allowed Layla Gay to make that quick re-entry back on the track after being exited to the infield.
50 seconds gone in this jam, and finally getting out the front. No, it is Bailey Wheat with a last-ditch effort, riding the hip out, and I believe she went out of bounds, a no pass, no penalty. That meant Layla Gay was able to come onto the track legally. Nice communication by her pack to let her know.
Yeah, absolutely, because she was starting to go all the way back, didn't need to, and it was a smart call by her pack and saved her a lot of time.
Elbowing penalty will send Machu Picchu to the penalty box. No points scored in that jam, Nerd.
No, and a lot of communication going on afterwards. Interesting, no points on the board on that jam. And with 3 minutes to go here in the second half, Kallio has actually pulled ahead in scoring in the second half, now leading 59-55 over Dallas. So continued late game strong play from the Kallio Rolling Rainbow. On the fast girl skate start line, it's going to be number 5, Jet, in the black for Dallas, up against number 72, Pretty Sick, for Kallio.
Pretty Sick goes to work on that back tripod, and out of the penalty box comes Blakely, and immediately goes into offensive mode, opens up that blocker formation that the All Colors had, and lead jammer is going to go to Jet.
Second in a row now for Dallas as they push back here late against Kallio.
And it just shows what well-timed offense can get you. Something that we've seen a lot in 2016, and Dallas doing a great job of it in this game. Tripod resets at the front. Blakely looking for an opportunity. Cracks into Schlagerhoff. Not enough to get her jammer out, but she is on a scoring pass. She is lead jammer, and Dallas once again has control of this jam. And the Dallas tripod at the back continuing to stymie Pretty Sick. Hannah Barbaric gets a shoulder into her, forces her out of bounds. That quick drawback by Mona Bruiser forces a track cut.
Continued strong play from Mona Bruiser in the pack. Not only can she deliver big hits, but also deliver smart plays, as we just saw there, to drag Pretty Sick into the penalty box. 3rd penalty of the half for Kallio Jammers.
Now at the front on the power jam, continuing to try to work her way free, is Jet. Jet is on a scoring pass, has not completed her first scoring pass, and then full passive offense, which we have not seen a lot of from Dallas in this game. Jets just get called off. She'll take 5 points, and they'll get a power start.
Yeah, passive offense is kind of fading away in the flat track game as we just realize that jammers need that help as the defenses get stronger and stronger and those braced walls become tighter and tighter.
And, you know, 30 seconds to work with in a power jam. Why waste 10 seconds allowing your trying to get your jammer to work the way to the front where you can have someone come in and blast the wall apart?
Absolutely, and we're finally starting to see that now. Jammer starting in the box for Kallio. Power start opportunity here for Dallas, and it's skated by Miley Virus, who is your lead jammer.
Yeah, Miley Virus, quick lateral movement allowing to find the gaps to freedom. Miley Virus approaching the back of the pack. Power jam over, pretty sick, out of the penalty box. All four blockers working on holding her back from the Dallas Derby Devils at the front. Miley Virus bumped to the inside by Dumi behind, now bumps up against Watuvima. Still working away back and forth. Great lateral movement by Miley Virus, forcing the blockers from Kallio to continuously reset their formation. Dumi behind seals off the inside. Now working to the outside, Matthew Bichu is going to have to drop off. And finally, working away through, great effort. Lots of energy expended, but 5 points picked up by Miley Virus. I love it.
And a star pass being made now to Matthew Bichu. So she is our jammer. And
Miley.
Fourth star pass of the game. That equals their total from all of the regular season now for Kallio.
Miley Virus takes a quick 4 points, sees Kallio is about to score, and calls it off. 10-0 in that jam.
Yeah, so Kallio didn't often do star pass as much, but they've been doing it a lot more here, and it looks like we've been drawn into an unofficial final. Captain Lou.
Yeah, time ran out in that game. Who knew?
Back game went by very, very quickly, and it looks like right now, unofficially, we have a 100-point victory for Dallas. But what a great second half yet again for Kallio Rolling Rainbow. And there you can see on your screen it is an official final now. Dallas moving on, and they will play once more again today, again 8 p.m. against Detroit. Looking for an opportunity to play for fifth place. Dallas now still can equal their placement as they entered in as the fifth seed into this tournament.
And the two teams that have traveled the farthest to get to Montreal, Derby Nerd, will play for ninth and tenth place tomorrow morning.
That's right, at 10 a.m. Any Kallio Sun State fans want to get up early, make sure you catch that one. It's our first set placement game for Championship Sunday, so we know that Kallio and Sun State will share ninth and tenth place, and it just remains to be seen on who will be where.
I think that game plays at midnight on Monday. Is that how it works in Australia? I don't know. It's timelines, all that, but it's just it's multiple hours away from where we are. Yeah, they have to get up late at night to watch Derby. Aussie fans very supportive of their teams as they travel to North America to compete. Perhaps one day we will get to travel to Australia to see division playoffs being played there.
Yeah, I think I'd be all right with that, actually.
Sure.
Be a nice trip.
I'm willing to wake up at 2 o'clock in the morning to watch roller derby in Australia.
Yeah, absolutely. So Dallas just taking their final lap now. And we do have a little bit of a gap now between games because this one did go by so quickly. But coming up next here at the WFTDA 2016 International Division One Playoffs, we've got a big showdown. It is our first semi-final showdown. Ooh. Bay Area Derby taking on Texas Roller Girls. The winner will advance to the championships.
Yep.
Remains to be seen whether they're the first or second seed, but we will know our first participant in the Division One Championship Tournament at around 3:30 p.m. or so this afternoon.
Yeah, I mean, the semifinals are always super exciting in the Division One playoffs. You book that ticket, you still have to play for a gold medal game the next day, but yeah, I'd like to see it go, Ed. Yeah, for sure.
And, of course, we do have another semifinal coming up at 6 p.m.
Somewhat important.
Somewhat important. Very historic showdown between London and Montreal.
These guys feel like they've played each other.
They've played each other a few times, and they've played each other a few times in the playoffs as well, too. So yet another chapter in the history of London and Montreal's rivalry coming up. And as we mentioned, we're going to continue with the consolation bracket semifinals, too. 4 p.m., Rocky Mountain and Boston. And Detroit and Dallas will meet at 8 p.m., as we've mentioned throughout this game.
All righty, Captain Lou Albamo, Derby Nerd. We're going to throw over to Electra Blue, who's got Guillotine Grace and Valhalla, I believe, from Kallio and Dallas.
That's right. I do have both captains here. We're having a little dance party while we're waiting for the guys to stop talking. First of all, congratulations. That was a hard-fought game on both parts. How did you feel going into that game?
Dallas felt prepared. We took a tough loss to Montreal last night, and we came in this morning. We were refocused, regrouped, and ready to play some good derby.
So you guys were both head-to-head on the track. That's why I thought I'd bring you head-to-head right now. So you had an interesting experience. So I know that it's your first time here, but you have had, last year you got to play Sun State, who were there, it was their first time, and the second time you're playing a first-timer. So we know that they have footage available to watch and this and that, but how do you prepare for a team that you've never even seen probably before?
Honestly, I don't think we watch a lot of film, so we're probably even anomaly in that, but we work really hard in practices, and we actually scrimmage the men, so we look at it like, you know, if we can shut down the guys every once in a while, we should be all right against some females, so we got this.
Well, yeah, that's got to be tough for sure. Now, of course, that game was a lot tougher than it looked. I know you both had defensive walls. Unfortunately, yesterday, a little bit of problems with the jammers and a little bit of that today, but how did you feel the second game on this floor?
Well, we were less nervous today, I think. We knew we were going to face a really tough opponent, so we were super excited and we were ready. We just thought that we're going to do what we can do best. And yeah, we did. I'm really, really proud and super excited to be here. Like these guys here, like I've been seeing them, I've been watching so many games, and now I'm here. This is just like, it's a dream come true. Really, really happy and proud. So.
Oh, and you guys are brand new too, only since 2014. All right, so tomorrow you get to go play Sun State, who you've played twice. Any advice?
Strong walls, baby, all day long.
And then tonight you have to go play Detroit. So what are you going to do going into that game? That's another strong wall team.
They have very diverse jammers. They have some strong pusher jammers. They also have some really jukey jammers. So we're going to have to adjust our walls a little bit to make sure that we're not leaving to run offense and leaving a hole. So we're going to do our best. We're going to give them a run for it.
Okay. And then tomorrow you got Sun State. So what do you got going on to that game?
I think we're going to use our strengths again. So we have really good walls. And hopefully our jammers, they were awesome today as well. I'm super proud of them. So yesterday was really hard, and we've learned from that. And yeah, we're only going to get better.
You're only going to get better, absolutely. All right, so any words for your fans at home?
Hi, Dallas. We love you guys. Thanks for the support.
And then how about you?
Well, hello, Finland. Hello, Helsinki. We're so happy that you're watching us.
And keep watching. We've got Bay Area and Texas coming up at 2 here on WFTDA.TV.